Hey folks, it's Rob. Welcome back to Fallout 4. Well, it's been a while since you last saw the game. Partly because I have been just trying to scavenge out the entire town. Now, that means I've been basically all over the place doing stuff. But there is one thing I left over here, and that is this. There's a house down the street. Let's put on the light here, since the natural light is fading. As you can see, we have a tension trigger and a makeshift bomb on a safe, and we also have a ledger terminal. So, I'm going to disarm the bomb, and the tension trigger, and we're going to unlock the safe. Oop, that one broke right away. Okay. Nearly. There we are.
Yes.
Always use some more ammo and our pipe pistol. Blah. More shotgun shells, though.
We won't be stopped by a little thing like a moth, will we, sir?
No, we will not, Codsworth. Codsworth, I have to say, is great. he is a much better companion than you might expect. We're going to now try to hack the terminal. What I find with the base, I find it to be the worst on the basic level puzzle, right? Because there are so many of these that are zero that it's actually not helpful. When there's like six characters, quite often you'll get like a two or three hit a match, and that makes it so much easier, in my opinion. So quite often I end up just basically kind of stabbing at these in the end. Right, I got likeness 1, which, until I click something else, we won't have any idea which character even to expect. But we know it's not Wave, because Wave has two of the same characters. So let's take, and it's not going to be Lake, or Maze, or Gate. But it could be Mole. It could be Abel. It could be Tall. It could be Rose. Let's try Tall. Right, so we still got a 1. Thing is, now we don't know if it's like the A that carried over or if it's actually a different character entirely that we didn't have before. Let's try Rose. Okay, see, still a 1. Right? I don't know. Fortunately, different from before, I'm going to try Mole. Alright, I'm locked out. Normally, in Fallout 3, this means this terminal's now dead to me for the rest of the game. Or until I stat up, I forget. You know, if I rank up, then it unlocks again. But the way they're handling it is basically a 10-second lockout. So now I could go back in and do it again. That saves a lot of the gaming it, where you just used to tab out before you got the final lock, so you just keep playing. Gray, no, nothing. Okay, so it's not going to be seed. Slip.
There we go.
Hey, we're in. Okay. So here we have some reports on people in the neighborhood. Turns out, someone was running a little drug operation here. Totally high strung, needs to relax. I keep telling him that, offering to help, but so far, no dice. By the looks of the guy, he's self-medicating with pie. Now, who doesn't like that? Dr. DiPietro. DiPietro enjoys his pie? Who's going to complain? My favorite tinfoil hat wearing nut job. Good for 7 ampules a day, tripper a week. Guess he's a one-a-day kind of guy. Whatever helps the man groove. So that's Baker. Rosa, still trying to get her some buff out. Didn't expect the rationing to affect this, but it is what it is. Rosa's house is the one with all the workshops and such across the road from my house. Jahani wants something called Psycho. Not sure they have that stuff even exists. And if it does, do I really want this Neanderthal using it? Guess it depends on how much he's willing to spend. I'll put some feelers out for my army connection, see where that goes. And Russell. They still owe me for that last Excel delivery. Occurred to me, was it even for them? Because, so help me God, if I find out they're juicing up those dogs, we're going to have words about more than just the money. But we're probably beyond words anyway. I know they have a floor safe in there. I've seen it. Master bedroom under the dresser. Can't be that tough to crack. So now you got a tip that somewhere around here is a floor safe under in the master bedroom. Some word on Concord, which is the town down the road, you might recall. And then Boston. Now, and here we have miscellaneous. We have Duchenne's and Malcolm. So again, more tips on where you might find loot. I've already kind of done this and come back to it again, because I have done some practicing in my own time. Because honestly, it takes like an hour and a half to render an episode. So, sometimes Rob just wants to play. but you can see this is the Hawthorne House, right? It's yellow. And it is just down the road from our house and the workshop house, which is just over here, this yellow one here. Now, you may be like, Rob, you need to heal up. You're like half health. And it is true. I was dealing with ineptly with some bloat flies, and there was a raider on the hill, kind of up over here behind these houses. He's got a shack where he's got a the body of a victim, and he has a dog. And the dog kind of chewed me up a bit, but my shotgun did deal with them. But this here is behind one of the houses up at the cul-de-sac. And before you start improving the town, spoilers, this is where you can sleep for a bit. This is also where there was a lot of nice loot, which I've already gotten to, but there is a safe here I don't yet have the ability to lock, unlock. But there is this bed here, which is what's important. Now, before I sleep, I am going to use a little Rataway. And let's have a nap. It's, you know, let's set out in the morning. That way we have daytime light, you know. So, I've done some improvements to my weapons, right? My shotgun now has long barrel. And I managed to, you can transfer mods between similar weapons. So that mistake I made where I put the glow sights on the wrong pistol, I managed to correct. So my pistol now has the glow sights, as you can now see. Nice to see this stuff demonstrated in game. So she's got the comfort. I'm gonna name it, because heck, I mean, if I'm gonna invest this much effort into my pistol, I might as well name it. So let's do that. Glow-sighted 10mm pistol is the default name at the moment. As you can see, it's got a standard receiver, short barrel, comfort grip, standard magazine. Now, what we can do is rename it. So hit T. And I'm going to keep it on 10mm pistol, but I'm going to lose glow-sighted. And I'm just going to name her Bestie. Because my bestie's always with me and got my back, you know? And here's my double-barrel shotgun with the long barrel now. It still has standard sights and short stock, but, you know, I can work on it. Here's a shitty pipe pistol, and I am just going to ditch that by scrapping it. Get me a bit more raw material. The workshop reservoir, as it were, is shared between this and this power armor station. Just so you're aware. So it's a good idea to just dump off your junk into the workshop station here, right? All this stuff will get broken down as needed into the component materials. As you can see, like, this enhanced targeting card is good for plastic, silver, and circuitry. And then here's, like, broken down material. Here's a gear. Here's glass. Here's some gold bars I managed to pick up. It's worth 10 gold each. Gold's not so much currency as it is a material. I mean, of course, you can sell junk to traders. And sometimes it is worthwhile to sell things. But honestly, if it's useful material, you should probably keep it for working on. Because improving settlements is certainly something that's going to come up. Now, let's head on out. Let's look at the old data. We've got a bright, nice morning here. Search the neighborhood with Codsworth. I guess I have to investigate Concord, honestly. Because I have not been able to get that to switch off for any other means. Now, instead of walking all the freaking way, let's get there the quick way, huh? Yeah. There's something I've not had the displeasure of running into yet. That looks freaking nasty, don't it? Didn't even know the East Coast has scorpions to begin with, so that'll be something that kind of moved into the area. But, yeah, they were in the D.C. wasteland. Right, so here we are in Concord. I have played some of this before, so we're just going to kind of get on. But there might be some stuff in the shops and things. You know, stuff is stuff. Here's one of our shops. I think I've already been around this one, though. If this is empty, yeah, I've already been through this one. There's a different shop. Yeah, across the road. There's a cap stash. 45 rounds and Med-X. Right now, I'm not in a huge hurry to go and get all the junk out of here. Just because I don't want to be overly burdened. Now, there it may be an R level up here, but you can... I have not been able to manage to get up there. You know, there's going to be fighting over here. Might as well just get this stuff, so... Codsworth does not approve of you picking up junk. Codsworth's like, you're hoarding out, sir. Why am I so yawny? I don't know. I guess it's relaxing to play the game. So, again, this is another one of those false sense of urgency kind of things. And I'm not about to get rushed out of here, so... There's a nice little hardware store here. You'd think those pipes would be something you could get, but they're not. Duct tape. Let me say that if out of all the junk that I ever run short of, it's adhesives. So, if you see duct tape or glue, you want it, okay? Because it's used for all kinds of stuff. If you're modifying your guns, if you're modifying your armor, you're going to want adhesives. And nothing back there. Somewhere around the upper level. Oops. May I say that you are certainly going to find dioramas with dummies and teddy bears throughout the game. Got the chem box. I'm not a big fan of using the chems, but, you know, to each his own. They're certainly valuable. Let's see, the church was over here. And again, in our sad little environment here, so many just like dead people lying around. Burnt textbook. I could grab that. I don't think it has any purpose. Here we have a guy hunched over another burnt textbook. There we go. Yeah, a short pipe rifle and a Molotov. Someone's been through here. Grab the old dust fan. Here's a safe.
Loctite.
Now, as you can see, it's an expert level safe. So, I forget. I think it's advanced, then expert. So I'd need to perk up twice to be able to unlock that. And up here is the bell tower, which I don't think there's anything actually up here. But you can see over here to the roof next door. And there's a vertibird crashed into the roof. That's going to become important later. You might be able to jump down here and not hurt yourself. I'm not going to risk it. This, though, you totally can. Oh, it looks like he flopped off the thing. All right. I don't think any of these houses over here are lootable, which is just annoying. I don't think there's anything up this way, although the Pulowski shelter might have something. I forget. Nope, it's an empty one. Lootable house here, which I may have already visited. Is it empty? Yes, it is. Okay. Yeah, because that's on the northern end of town, and I'm pretty sure I covered that in the previous video. Right, so let's carry on with the main quest, right? Right. So I'm going to pick up the musket, and I'm going to go inside, and we're going to have a fight. Now, important, pick up the fusion cells as well. Okay. You didn't have to pick up the musket, but I would suggest that you do so, as it is actually a decent weapon in its own way. You got to use it the right way. So, short laser musket. Let's add it to the presets. We'll put it on 4 over here. So right now I have my pistol. Well, I have the tire iron on 1. I have the pistol on 2. Double barrel shotgun on 3, and then I have the musket on 4. You can equip grenades, but I actually have no idea how to throw them yet. Right. So let's crack out the musket and show you. Right. So here it is. You load it by cranking. Right. This takes a fusion cell and primes it. You can crank it twice. Right. This is the most you can crank the base level short musket. Now, cranking it twice means that you do more damage. Cranking it once, you can certainly do and still fire. And you might be able to hear a very faint hum coming from the gun now. This means it is ready to fire. If I fire the gun, and I am in FPS mode like I am right now, the gun will not auto-reload. I have to crank it by hitting R. If I am in VATS mode and I fire it and select multiple shots, it will automatically crank it and fire it again. So that's a point of distinction to keep in mind. You know, I was up on the roof. I totally forgot about that. I don't think there's anything on that, but I totally forgot about the fire escape there. So let's head on in to the museum. I'm gonna hide. There are more than a few raiders available, unfortunately. Right, see, here's a couple of them right now. Now, there's one. I think I missed. That was a real tight shot, to be honest. Right, let's make life easier on ourselves. We'll come around this way. You can see I've been hurt. Use the old stim pack. You gotta kind of plan ahead on this now. You can't just go and use one whenever you can't use like 10 stim packs and just stay alive, right? I have been in here on occasion when this has actually been very much intact. It's usually knocked around. That's me admitting I have died on a few occasions here. And I'll be absolutely frank with you, I failed to record one of my playthroughs here when I was first playing. So I've had been left with no choice but to actually just kind of come at it again. Over here is, yeah, the pay window for the, like, ticket office. Some bits.
Come on out. I'll make it nice and quick. You can trust me.
Down here's the basement, right? This terminal opens this door.
When you turn up.
I can also just unlock it. Just a bit to the side, down to the other side. Here we are.
Got it.
This is a fusion core. You want these. I could still mess with this for XP.
No sign of them now.
I don't really feel like doing that right now. Buff out. We came in through there. Yeah, we're going this way. I'm not even hiding. Alright, we'll try for the headshot. Now, see, like, I've set up three shots. Kablam! And then we cranked. See? Won't do that regular for you. Alright. What else we got here? Nothing. I'm trying to move through quickly, but at the same time, I don't want to leave shit behind, because I am a fucking pack rat. Dust fan. Oh, there was a fuse. Fuses are great. They contain copper. Copper's another resource that'll come into short supply if you start working with electrics. Cap stash. Everyone loves caps. This is the guy we killed when we first came in. Now, I can go this way, right? Or I can go this way. There is a door over here. Sometimes it requires a little finesse to get in, as you might appreciate. Oop, bobby pin box. Forgot about that. As you can see, I've been ditched down to the other side.
No more British occupation.
jackanapes. No taxation without representation. Oof, such a wide brogue. Alright, so we'll do this the traditional hard way. Now, because of the nature of this gun, I'm going to switch to the shotgun. Because this is going to be more of a close range encounter. That red will explode. And there are several explodey barrels in this room. Yes, I did. And since you're hiding near that, well, he threw a Molotov at us, and I am on fire. Alright. Again, keep yourself from dying. Now, I did want to do this the hard way because basically, this is where the loot is. There's loot here, and, you know, what can I say? I want loot. Should I pass up on loot? Hell no. Everybody loves loot. It was just Memorial Day. Thank you. Thank you, those of you who have served. My nephew Daniel's currently serving. My uncle Marion had served. Now, this will make noise if I try to loot this while I'm hiding. Come on. Find out what happened to your buddy. Find out what happened to your buddy. There you are. Thank you. They get knocked around a little, so yeah, see, like, he's all the way down the hallway. So just because you drop somebody doesn't mean they're going to stay there. Microscope, alarm clock, those are nice things. Microscope has, like, high-tech elements to it. And the alarm clock has nuclear material and small, fine components, which are very useful. Alright. Again, the guy's like going, come on, get in here. And I'm like, no, I'm busy looting. There's stuff to get. You know? Have your priorities straight. Put the gun away for sake of propriety. This right here, first thing to do. Perfect. The Atomic Command holotape game is now included in this. Alright. So we're talking to this guy now.
Minutemen?
Protect the people at a minute's notice. That was the idea. So I joined up, wanted to make a difference. And I did, but things fell apart. Now it looks like I'm the last Minuteman left standing.
So who are these people?
Just folks looking for a new home, a fresh start. I've been with them since Quincy. Lexington looked good for a while, but the ghouls drove us out of there. A month ago, there were 20 of us. Yesterday, there were 8. Now we're 5. It's just me, the Longs, Marcy and June. That's old Mama Murphy on the couch. And this here Sturgis.
Hey. So, I know what ghouls are. The character doesn't know what ghouls are. I mean, you've been along with this ride. He's basically woke up from 200 years ago, like, yesterday.
Ghouls? What are ghouls?
Wow. You really aren't from around here, are you? Ghouls are irradiated people. Most are just like you and me. They look pretty messed up and live for a long time. But they're still just people. The ones I'm talking about are different. The radiations rotted their brains, made them feral. They'll rip you apart just as soon as look at you. Anyway, we figured Concord would be a safe place to settle. Those raiders proved us wrong. But, well, we do have one idea.
Let's hear it.
Sturgis. Tell him.
There's a crashed vertebrate up on the roof. Old school. Pre-war. You might have seen it. Well, looks like one of its passengers left behind a seriously sweet goodie. We're talking a full suit of Cherry T-45 power armor. Military issue.
Now, you know, that sounds pretty sweet. And as a former... as the character is itself a veteran. So, yeah, sounds
that's
useful.
Serious protection.
Oh, it gets better. Get the suit. You can rip the minigun right off the vertibird. Do that, and those raiders get an express ticket to hell. You dig?
Sounds like a great idea.
Now we're talking.
I know, right? Only there's one hitch. The suit's out of juice. Probably been dry for 100 years. It can be powered up again. But we're a bit stuck.
So, what's the solution?
What you'll need is an old pre-war FC. A standardized fusion core. Your high-grade, long-term nuclear battery used by the military and some companies way back when. We know right where
to
find it.
But we can't get to the damn thing. It's down in the basement. Locked behind a security gate. Look.
You don't say.
I fix stuff. I tinker. Bypassing security ain't exactly my forte. You could give it a shot.
In my experience, tinkering and bypassing physical security go hand in hand. But that's another matter. I already got it.
Actually, I already grabbed the fusion core. We're set.
Well, all right. Maybe our luck's finally turning around. Once you jack the core into the power armor... grab that minigun, those raiders will know they picked the wrong fight. Good luck.
So, Museum Operations Terminal could mess with that. I think there's a small amount of loot in here, and you're not going to really want to have to come back. That's Mama Murphy. That's your bobblehead that you want. Increase your perception by 1. Why would you not? This here is Jun Long. He's got problems. That's his wife, Marcy Long. She's got anger issues. Of the people who you're going to be associating with, these are the only quality ones right here. These are the hapless losers of your community. Now, well, except for Codsworth, sorry, dude, I didn't realize you were there, standing there at the time. This is the doorway out to the, that balcony he was summoning you from. And, you know, I haven't actually gone out there. I don't know if there's anything actually out there on the ledge. It'll be worth looking. Shooting at this thing? Alright, let's wind her up. So, yeah, we're under attack. I didn't think we'd get things underway like that by walking outside. So, I guess I gotta move on. This would be a place for a cut. So, Thank you very much for watching. Join us next time as we pick up that suit of power armor, and we're going to have a nice big set-piece fight. Would you mind? I'm trying to close off here. Fucking Marcy Long. I should just shoot you one day. Right. Back next time. Bye, folks.